That tobacco wars that Charlie just mentioned there are certainly escalating in Melbourne. A store in the city's north firebombed for a second time, the 28th shop targeted so far this year. Let's bring in Theo Ficarri, who's the CEO of the Australian Association of Convenience Stores. Theo, thanks for your time this morning. I mean, these attacks we're seeing on tobacco stores are relentless. We just saw that Hadfield store firebombed again, the second time in 2 months. Why are they being targeted like this?
Yeah, good morning, Sarah. Look, illegal tobacco and illegal vaping in Australia is at a crisis point. And it really comes back to failed policy settings by both the federal and state governments. But the size of the prize we're talking about here is more than $5 billion per year in lost excise. And we're forced into a situation where currently we have next to no enforcement, and the fines for people caught doing this wrong, doing the wrong thing, is basically next to nothing. So they'll continue to do this, and the problems are only going to get worse. On top of that, Australia has the highest cigarette prices in the world, and vaping products are banned. So until we've got the right policy settings, we're going to see more and more of this. So we really do need action quickly.
Well, this is the problem, isn't it? I mean, it's an industry that's far too lucrative now for criminals.
Yeah, look, absolutely. And if I look at what's happening in Victoria, Victoria stands alone as the only state without a licensing scheme. Mm. So there's no framework on who can sell it. And at the end of the day, we have the wrong people actually going after these illegal operators. We've got local council officers and health inspectors that, to be frank, they're not trained to be able to deal with this. So while that's the case, unfortunately, we're going to continue to see this happen. Yeah. And in Victoria, the government has been sitting on a report for almost 2 years now, which clearly outlines what they need to do to fix the problem. But they haven't even released the report yet. So we've been calling on the Allen government to release it, to make it public, so that everyone knows, the community can start to feel safe, that there is action happening.
Well, that seems like a no-brainer. I mean, we've got these attacks playing out in suburbia. It's only a matter of time before somebody gets injured desperately. Like, this is not something to just ignore. It needs to be addressed now. And at the end of the day as well, you've got these store owners who are copping the brunt.
Yeah, look, I have calls regularly from retail owners. They're firstly concerned about their staff, all right? They want to make sure that their staff are safe in the environment that they go to work in, because these attacks can happen any day, at any time of the day. And the second part is retailers are sick and tired of reporting these illegal operators to all of the authorities, and we're just not getting the action that we need.
You mentioned that report hasn't been released yet. What would you like to see done?
Yeah, look, it's a threefold approach that needs to happen. Firstly, in Victoria, the government needs to make the report public so that they can introduce a new licensing scheme that has the same approach as liquor. You'll have to pass a fit and proper persons test. You'll have to have a criminal background check. They'll increase the fines significantly, like I'm talking in the hundreds of thousands of dollars. And they'll put the right people in charge, not the health officers, not the local council officers. They'll put the right people in charge to be able to go out and bust open this black market and make people feel safe. Separately, at a federal level, we've been calling on the Albanese government to actually appoint a national commissioner for illegal tobacco and illegal vaping products so that they can actually have the right department going after it, not sitting across multiple departments. And it needs to sit in Home Affairs. Mm. It's a Home Affairs issue because it's coming in at the border and it's being sold through these stores. So that's what needs to happen. And finally, Sarah, the vaping, because the vaping crisis that we're seeing is directly linked to the illegal tobacco crisis. It's the same operators. And whilst it remains banned, we're going to end up with this being freely sold to children. So they really need to get serious. And they're the three things that all levels of government need to do urgently.
Some pretty simple measures there, Theo. Thanks for your time this morning.